Today we have a double feature. Yep, that's right. We are going to award Renato in Brazil with a snake and chicken award for his great question. And just as a reminder, this is supposed to be all in good fun, okay? So when something is going to start smelling like snake oil to our listeners, then we give the snake award. And when it's going to start a whole bunch of people chicken clucking about stuff, we give a chicken award. So this is the first who gets a chicken and a snake award for this great question. And Renato asks, is it possible to measure sound quality? Yeah, you see where this is going? Can you take instruments and figure out a parameter that would classify if an amplifier is good or not, or nothing, or something that replaces the human ear? You know, is there any way to do that? Is it possible for an amp, for instance, with high THD to sound better than an amp with low THD? And essentially, you know, are there measurements that matter when it comes to sound quality? And the simple answer is it depends who you are asking and what they're looking for. So if I have an amplifier that's got 10% distortion, 20% distortion, it's a badly distorted waveform, I've got equipment all over this shop that can measure down to, you know, thousands of a percent. So yeah, I can tell you right now that amp isn't going to sound bad. If we have an amplifier or a preamplifier whose frequency response is rolled off or there's something wrong with it, I can measure that easily. I can tell you that there's something wrong, but it's about as far as it goes. After that, there are no current means that I am aware of measuring sound quality. How we can take one amplifier and measure it against another amplifier and say this one, because that number is higher or lower, is better than that one in terms of sound quality. Now, this is a classic conundrum, because on the one camp, there's an easy out to this, right? And all dogmatic views on both sides, okay? I don't care, Republicans and Democrats, cults, I mean, people with strong beliefs in either way always have their outs, right? We do, the flat earth people do. So here's a good one. If two amplifiers measure the same, they sound the same, right? That's an easy out. So yes, of course, if it measures differently, I agree. In most cases, it'll sound different. But if they measure the same, then they have to sound the same. And that's patently not true. And, you know, I'm not going to argue that with people, because they have very strong beliefs that I'm wrong. What they're missing is that we're not able to measure everything. We can't measure, for instance, how the brain perceives certain timing cues. We don't know. We've made a lot of progress into that. Some researchers that have been working very hard on three-dimensional sound know a hell of a lot more than we do about what impacts sound quality. And they've done some amazing work. But generally, in our industry, in if you're Sony, if you're Yamaha, if you're making consumer electronics, we don't know how to say this amplifier, who has the same frequency response and the same THD and the same IM, how it's going to sound. You just can't. And I can easily demonstrate on a highly resolving system, on even a decently resolving system, I can easily demonstrate the difference in sound quality. Some will sound compressed. The imaging will change. The timbre. Timbre is a great word. Timbre, of course, means it's a word that describes our ability to tell one instrument from another. It if we can maintain the harmonic integrity of instruments, because it is those harmonics that when we play a clarinet, there's a fundamental, let's say you're playing 440, you know, I don't know if clarinets play 440, but anyway, from a piano it's A440. When you're playing that fundamental frequency, the difference between a piano note and a clarinet is all in the harmonics and the envelope of how it starts and stops. So that's basically timbre. And those things, while I can, even on my cheap earbuds, I can tell the difference between a clarinet and a piano. I can't necessarily tell that this one is a Bösendorfer and this one is a Steinway, which I might be able to do on our system because it's more highly resolving. And certain instruments, this being an instrument, certain products make that easier to define those. And we don't know, and I don't know anybody that does, a means of measuring that. Someday, I hope so, it should be measurable, but currently it's not. Thanks for a great question, and congratulations on the award. Bye.